It's important for you to know the process behind instituting insulin dose adjustments. Why might this be important for you? The reason is because between visits, you want to be able to adjust your insulin plan with or without the assistance of your doctor. I want to go over the thought process behind adjusting insulin doses. This video is not intended to take the place of your physician's guidance, so please seek their help with any specific questions. The goal is just to give you insight into how your endocrinologist might be thinking about your insulin plan and how you can think about it at home as well. That way you don't have to wait until your visit in 3 months to make some adjustments if you're noticing high or low blood sugars. The first thing you want to do is look for patterns. How might you look for patterns? Well, first of all, you have to know what your blood sugars are. So the more data you have, the better. There's a couple ways for you to get this data. One would be to look at your glucometer over the past 3 days and write down your numbers. Your goal is to have at least 4 blood sugar checks in a day over those 3 days. So if that's not something you're doing already, this is a great time to get started. You want to be having blood sugar checks before meals, so breakfast, lunch, and dinner, and then also at bedtime. It's great to also know what your blood sugar is overnight, but understandable if it's difficult to come by this data. Another way to get this information is through your continuous glucose monitor, CGM. You can look at your Dexcom and see your blood sugar trends over the past 3 days. If you need assistance with this, you can ask a parent or friend as well to help you with sharing the information from their Dexcom Clarity app. Or you can ask the clinic when you visit as well how you might go about getting that data. The other thing you want to do is know what you're looking for and what your goals are. The goal for your average blood sugar should be about 154. That would equal a hemoglobin A1C of 7%. When you're looking at your blood sugars, you also want to see about 70% of them in goal range. That means you're spending 16 hours of your day between 70 to 180 for your blood sugar. You want to have low blood sugars or blood sugars less than 70, 4% of the time or less, and then you want to minimize high blood sugars as much as possible. During the day, your blood sugar goal is about between 90 to 150 when you started eating, and then first thing in the morning, about 90 to 130. So if you're outside of this range, it may be time to make some adjustments. Once you've reviewed your patterns and collected all your data, now it's time to figure out why these patterns are occurring. So let's talk about high blood sugars first. When your blood sugar's high, usually that's a sign that you're not getting enough insulin. So let's talk about some patterns you might see. If you're noticing your blood sugar is rising overnight, that can be because you're not getting enough long-acting insulin. So that might mean that you need to increase your Lantus, your Basaglar, your Semglee, or other brands of long-acting insulin, or increase your basal rate. A good rule of thumb is to increase by about 10%. So if your Lantus dose is 20 units a day, going up to 22 units is reasonable to try. If your basal rate is 1 unit per hour, going up to 1.1 units per hour is reasonable to try. Other times your blood sugar might be high would be during the day, and a common time to see that is after meals. If you're noticing highs after your meals, you have to consider, am I giving enough carb coverage? Am I guessing on my carbs? Do I need to count more accurately? Might it be my food choice where I'm eating really starchy, carb-heavy foods and then my blood sugar's high afterwards? Could you be giving your insulin too late? Insulin takes 15 to 20 minutes to work, so if you're giving it after you eat, it may be that the insulin isn't working quickly enough for you and you need to be giving it before you eat. If you're already doing well with those things, it might be time to adjust your carb ratio. Your goal is to adjust it so that you get about 1 to 2 more units of insulin per meal. So consider it this way. If you're eating 50 grams of carbs and your carb ratio is 10, you would get 5 units for that meal. But if you change that to 8, you may be getting more like 6 units per meal. That's a pretty reasonable change in your insulin dose. That's about a 1 unit change. If you're noticing low blood sugars, think of the opposite things. You may be overestimating on the number of carbs you're eating per meal, or you may be eating simple carbs, and so the insulin you're giving is too much for that type of meal. So you may want to add protein and healthy fats to that meal. Or perhaps you're giving the full dose of insulin, but you're about to exercise. Another reason for low blood sugars may be that your sliding scale is too much. If you're noticing low blood sugars after you have a high, that may be a reason why and you need to back off on your sliding scale. Or in your pump, it may be your correction factor, which takes the place of your sliding scale. To adjust that, you could consider, once again, changing it by about 1 unit. So if your correction factor is 30, you may change that to 25. Whereas if it's 50, you may change that to 40 or 45 and see if that helps. You could also change your target to a lower number. So if it's 130, you could change it to 120. You also want to notice if you're having high blood sugars after a low blood sugar. If that's occurring, you're probably taking in too many carbs when your sugar is low. If you're usually taking in 15 grams, consider reducing it to 10. Or if you're usually eating the whole pantry after your blood sugar's low, try to restrict that to 15 grams of fast-acting carbs. And don't forget, not all carbs are created equal. So try to use fast-acting carbs for your low blood sugars, meaning juice, candy, fruit snacks, fruit, glucose tabs, not peanut butter jelly sandwiches. For any other information on adjusting your insulin plan, we do recommend you contact your endocrinology team. These are just guidelines to help you get started and feeling more comfortable making adjustments at home. The first time you make adjustments, you might consider running that plan by your endocrinologist to see if you got the thought process right.